Good, you're back. I'm Neom, and today's episode is about boring animals. Before we get started, a quick thank you to everyone for subscribing. A few days ago, we hit 200 subs, only two videos after hitting 100, and it's been really exciting and encouraging seeing all the support and reading all of the amazing comments. Really, I couldn't do it without you. If you're new to the channel and want to be a part of this journey, leave a like and hit the subscribe button. It really helps. And now, before my audience retention completely goes down the tubes, let's get into it. Boring animals. You might have thought this video would be about some of the more sleepy animals like sloths or pandas. Or maybe you were thinking of the slower beasts like turtles and snails. But the focus for this video is actually animals that bore, or burrow into the ground. I'll skip some of the more well-known ones like mice, ants, and Laura Ingalls Wilder, and try to cover a few of the ones that I think are more interesting. First up is the pangolin. Hailing from Southeast Asia and Central Africa, these little fellas primarily eat ground-dwelling insects like spiders, fleas, and ants, which makes sense as they are closely related to the anteater, or Myrmecophaga tridactyla. Wow, it's so cool how you just know the Latin name off the top of your head. Unlike the anteater, pangolins use their large, powerful claws to dig burrows for themselves to live in. Whenever threatened or provoked, the pangolin will curl itself into a ball and trust its hard scales to protect it from predators until it can retreat into its hole. It'll also occasionally whip its sharp tail around to fend off the offenders. For any humans watching this, the lesson to be learned here is that a tail is a far better tool for lashing out than Facebook. Next up, the burrowing urchin. Found in the Indo-Pacific region of the ocean, burrowing urchins live off the algae from rocks, or sometimes seaweed if they're feeling bougie. These guys are unique in that, instead of burrowing into sand or dirt, they burrow directly into the limestone, using their hard teeth to scrape at the rock until they have a divot big enough. Another interesting fact about urchins is that not only are they the only sea creature that bores into stone, they're also the only creatures that wear hats. Urchins will take shells and rocks and nudge them around to be positioned on top of them to be used as camouflage. Some people have even made little plastic hats for their pet urchins to wear. If you Google urchin hat, you'll find a ton of hilarious images of the dapper little guys. Mouse spiders. Not to be confused with the spider mouse, mouse spiders come from Australia and Chile. While burrowing itself isn't exactly uncommon in the Spider-Verse, mouse spider homes have some pretty high-tech features. The mouse spider digs their hole anywhere from 8 to 22 inches in length and lines the interior with silk. This acts as support and catches any wanderers that might dig in from outside. They also have an openable door within their tunnel, leading to a chamber specifically made to keep their egg sac. Similar to the mouse spider is the trapdoor spider, who also digs into the ground and lines their tunnel with their web. Trapdoor spiders cover their holes on the surface of the ground with grass and dirt, acting as a trapdoor that they can spring out of to catch prey. The silk lining on the inside of their holes lets them know when predators or food are nearby, and the videos you can find are pretty terrifying to behold. Though it might be unfortunate even for benign visitors. Excuse me. Excuse me, I was wondering if— Did you know another name for a burrow is a warren? This word is more commonly used for rabbit holes, and it originated when a rabbit went out for a drink with one of his friends. You know, Warren, you might be the most hair-brained person I've ever met. Hey man, why you always gotta be digging into me? From then on, whenever a rabbit would dig into the ground, you would remember Warren. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe for more content, ring the bell to be notified about new videos, and comment what you want to learn about next. I'm Neom, and I'll see you next time.